confidence, Preston found the going tough, and it was South Melbourne that took an early territorial advantage. Oscar Crino set up Murphy for a shot after playing the ball in here to Brown. Young goalkeeper Trinides got an early test and put the ball over the bar. Big Steve Blair was causing trouble at corners, and this effort was deflected over by Ilioski. Preston were in more trouble soon after, and it was again Blair on the far post, this time rising to meet Brown's cross and sending it narrowly past the post. But South Melbourne certainly didn't have it all their own way, and Preston battled very hard in midfield. Flavelle and Ilioski were outstanding, and Lane, working hard up front, combined well with his defenders coming forward. Here, Opisenis is stopped by Blair, one of South Melbourne's best players on the day, and from the resulting free kick, Preston had one of their better moves. It was Lane with the kick, and it was Cole coming in with a header, found Hayes, but the angle was too great, and again it was that man Blair to clear for a corner. Preston came out fighting in the second half, and one of their key players was Warren Spink, whose great speed worried the South Melbourne defence. Here Spink eluded John Idesendorn and took off on a great run, getting past two South Melbourne defenders before hitting a shot into the side netting. But it was South Melbourne Hellas that looked far more dangerous in the forward line. The loss of Opisenis from the Preston defence seemed to unsettle them, and soon after, Brown hit the post. McDowell and Murphy did the lead-up work, and Trinides was beaten. From the cross that came back in, Hayes cleared and Preston lived again. Brown, the top goalscorer last year in the NSL, had a great chance soon after, and the fact that he's missing these puts him in the same boat as Cole in a way. Great forwards who just can't find the net. Dunn made the mistake, and Egan unselfishly passed to Brown. It seemed he had the goal at his mercy, but Trinides again covered himself well and put the ball out. Preston continued to push players forward, but found the South Melbourne defence a tough nut to crack. However, on this occasion, Cole worked the ball nicely to Spink, and the cross by Lane almost was met by Cole. Trinides, in the Preston goal, was fast becoming his team's hero. Called in at the last minute when Richard Wilson was injured, he made several saves. The save of the match came when McDowell sent a pile driver towards the top corner, but in acrobatic fashion, Trinides was there, pushing the ball wide. The young Preston goalkeeper was in great form, but it seemed only a matter of time before South Melbourne got a goal. The winner came in the 74th minute after Crino again was involved. Skillfully working his way past the Preston midfield here, Crino then found Brown on the edge of the penalty area, and it was the overlapping McDowell who supplied the cross for Egan on the far post for a superb goal. Egan's goal sealed the game for South Melbourne and gave them a measure of revenge after twice losing to Preston this season. The fact that they were the better team on the day was conceded by Preston coach Billy Murray.
They played very well. They made it very tight all over the park, and we didn't counteract that as well as we should have done. No excuses. I thought we had chances. They had most of the game. They probably deserved to win on the day.
Preston coach Billy Murray talking with Kyle Patterson, and what a super goal by Charlie Egan winning the match for South Melbourne.